Hi, I'm Michelle Akins. There isn't a column this month for me. Instead, here's my column, Your Prime Time. Hi, I'm Michelle Akins, and I didn't write an article for this issue of the magazine. I didn't write an article because I wanted to talk to you. This issue represents 1 year that Sepia Prime Woman has been in distribution. And it's been a very interesting and eventful year. The reason I think it's important to say this is because we all have anniversaries of some sort. Some we celebrate with joy, and some we remember thinking, oh yeah, this is the anniversary of a death, or the loss of a job, or a divorce. But an anniversary period is a time when we mark the passing of time as it relates to something. Now, that's not Webster's dictionary definition, that's mine. And so when we talk about celebrating an anniversary, I want you to remember three things. One, time passed. So whether you were doing something really hard that you think you didn't think you could do, or it was joy all the way, you get to mark off the passing of time. When I was growing up, my mother used to mark off our growth every year on the wall, and we could see our progress. Anniversaries allow us to see the progress that we've made. Even if it's regarding an unpleasant circumstances or an unpleasant circumstance, you are still here. Celebrate the fact that you are still here. The other thing I want you to remember is the process of the event that you're celebrating, whether it's painful or whether it's joyful, some of your instincts were involved. You got a notion, you got an instinct, an idea to do something because you thought it would work out better for you. And even though things may not have turned out exactly as you wanted, like with Sepia Prime Woman, I suspect you can look at where you are now and some of your instincts have been validated. That's because God lives in you and He is there to guide and direct you if you trust His voice. And so another thing that we can celebrate when anniversaries come is I had a hunch, I had an instinct, I followed it through, and you know what? I'm further along than I was this time last year. The last thing I want you to consider as you ponder the anniversaries in your life are the people who started with you and where they are now. This has been an interesting year for me in terms of working relationships and friendships and all of that other stuff, because when you decide to pursue an instinct, sometimes it's going to cause problems with people who are comfortable with you just where you are. And that can be hard, but that is also part of the process. And so you cannot have moving forward the next thing without the process of separation for some people who don't want to go. We're going to take a deep breath now, think about them, and let them go. We're going to be grateful for the experiences that we had with them, and we're going to embrace what's next. Because God never takes and leaves you in a deficit. When something has to leave, God, if you are patient and trust Him, will put back more. So I want to celebrate a year of moving boldly, a year of doing things that we didn't think we could do this time last year. And I also want to celebrate the nerve to keep going. Yeah, I told you I had three things. That's the fourth one. An anniversary is a reminder that you've come this far, you may as well keep going. So here's to you and another year of moving boldly. I want to remind you, as I always do, you are anointed to do something great. So make it your business to go about doing it right now.